But if they can't see it, then it's their shame, actually. So why this APIOps cycles and automation is fundamentally important? People are lazy bastards by default. We don't want to do anything that it's not necessary to do. We minimize the work and effort normally. And clever people still get things done. Some people don't use it and they do the same stuff again and then again and again until they just and they stop. Clever people find a way to automate everything. And APIOps is about the community, is about finding ways to do standardized API value chain automation. And in that purpose, before you can even start using any kind of tools or selecting tools, you have to have a set of methods to use. And that's the cycles part of it. So it's a framework for doing something API development in your organization, API or just one person, but get all on board. How do we do it? The tools that you actually need. We know, probably every one of us, that the stores and warehouses are now being automated more and more. Alibaba is doing this. Amazon has been doing this. Why should API development be any different? You probably want to automate the whole process as much as possible. You can't automate, at least not yet, the interaction with the developers or API consumers completely, but you want to do everything as automatically as possible. And it's going to happen anyway. So let's automate things and let us be lazy, but at the same time, let's be productive. That's the fundamental idea of APIOps cycles. It involves API testing. You want to automate that. Or contribution to your code base, except that you want automatically to be tested. Tests are all green, you want it to be automatically built. Is successful and everything else is successful, you want it to be automatically deployed. Manually, you want to do automation. But it also involves automation related to API management, where actually you want to, that's your gateway to publishing your APIs. API portals, which are normally part of API management. And you need to push, for example, a new documentation version into the API management, again, automatically. Think about scaling the API. You don't want to be sitting in front of the screen and seeing that CPU is now 89%, now it's 95%. You want the system to do it. You don't want your users to call you and ask for API key. They want it instantly. You want that automatically. Turning off the APIs automatically. So basically, there's a lot of stuff that you can actually and what you should automate in building the APIs and managing the APIs. Don't be fooled about this picture. It looks like a full model, but actually it's my lack of drawing skills, so it should be actually a circle like in lean startup model. So it goes on again and again and again. So, but then there's some steps that normally are included in API development and even publishing it to the who are actually the developers. And there's the elements of reasons for it, then making the design, testing the design out with the developers or prospect users, and then the testing and then the deployment and putting it in the API management for everyone to use. But all of these parts and all the nuances are in the APIOps sorry, cycles.apiops.net address. So it's a set of tools and methods for designing API management compatible APIs, business orientation, and are designed with in align with best practice regarding the architecture. There's a spelling error, patterns, actually. That's the one sentence nutshell itself. So it's not, no, it's not a software that you install. It's something that you learn, specific software for the pieces in the cycle. Canvases, checklists, process descriptions, principles, and it's, as I said, it's software agnostic. Our task, actually, this APIops community define how it is implemented. Some of the parts, or there, the nice lady in the couch, selects one part of the process and finds a way to do it with, let's say, 3 or 5 tools, how to do this wisely, and then comes up here and tells us, yes, I took this part of the cycles model, and I took this software, and then I needed to do this, and then I accomplished this. And if this information is shared inside the community, we all learn from it, and then others fill in the missing blanks again, and we can improve the model all the time with practical results. That's the idea. So why I was eager to get out this cycles model out is that it gives us the glue for the meetups. Why do we do this? And there's something to attach actually all the time. So get familiar with it. I'm not going to go through the website there, so you can probably read, every one of you. So material, it's not complete. It's not high, and it's definitely not ready. It will be never ready. It's always changing and improving. That's the idea. Get familiar with it. And as I said, show us how you would do some parts of it. Come here on the stage and show everyone how you did it or how you plan to do it. Then contribute to the model itself. If you find flaws in it, make a suggestion as an issue that, hey, this could be possibly better to do this way, or you define this way, or add a step here, something like that. And that raising the issues happens in GitHub. And then there's also the process description, how the versions, sorry, there's the master branch and the development branch, and what you should do actually to contribute there. So there's step-by-step instructions actually in the GitHub now. Relatively easy to follow. Well, basic principle is everything goes to the development branch, and from there it's accepted. That's basically it. I'm not going to go through all of this. I'm not even sure should the business side of it even be presented in this technical community, or is it somewhere else? There isn't too many tools actually to automate the business logic, how to define the business and layers and everything else and do the planning. So this audience might not be the right audience to go with in details. But rest of the model is practical stuff, but the beginning is more or less about business people related. But even getting familiar with that kind of thinking helps you, even though you might be technically oriented. So you would actually understand what the business people are thinking and where they come from, and if they can actually the canvas with the business canvas to you what we aim to have, it's easier for you as a technical guy to actually implement it, and it's a communication tool between the business and technical people.